What if the residuals are not normal? If the residuals are not normal, you can try to transform the data. Or you can say, hey, I'm going to use a non-parametric test. And the non-parametric counterpart of a one-way ANOVA is a Kruskal-Wallis test. Yeah. So if the residuals are not normal, you do a transformation or you go for this function. How does this function work? Exactly the same as LM. Yeah, it needs a formula that looks like this, where X will define more than two groups. Yeah. Then you are in the case of the Kruskal-Wallis test. And also here, this function is very sensitive to the fact that X needs to be a factor, or he will complain. Now, that being said, this transformation that I mentioned already a few times, that always assumes that you have continuous data. Eh? If you have discrete data, it can never be normally distributed. And it is also not allowed to do transformations on discrete data. So if you have discrete data, you're automatically here in this case, in the Kruskal-Wallis test. And in the Wilcoxon test, if you have only two groups that you want to compare. How does it work in R? So as an example, I'm working here with, let's run empty cars. So I'm working here not with the gas usages, not with the MPG column, but with a column called CARP that I don't find, with this one. And as you can see, this column does not contain continuous data like MPG does, but it contains discrete data. Eh? So for this analysis, if the data that I'm going to work with is discrete, I have to use a Kruskal-Wallis test. How does the test work? Well, the same, you give him a formula. So this is the data that I measured, yeah? And the data is modeled by, I want to model it by, the groups that are defined in the gear column. So in the column that you see here. And this is the data set. I do the Kruskal-Wallis test and I retrieve a p-value. P-value is higher than 0.05, so I do not have enough evidence to say that there is something going on in my data.